I finally finished building this crazy pantorouter demo machine, and now I gotta ship it. But because I spent so much time on that machine, I haven't had time to build much else, so in this video I'm just gonna build a shipping crate for it. And I've already cut the plywood for this thing, but because this stuff is only about 1 centimeter thick, I'm gonna reinforce it in the corners with this, which is just a 2x6 that I ripped into strips. So these strips will reinforce the edges like this, and just to make it sturdy, I'm going to join the corners with box joints. I cut the box joint with my trusty old box joint jig, and to make it go faster, I stacked two blades in the saw so I get a wider kerf, and I worked out where on the gear I have to make the second cut, which is where this piece of tape is. So let's get cutting. The mating pieces need to be 1/4 inch offset, and since I do two turns of this gear for each finger, I'm just going to start this one turn offset. Because my workbench is presently occupied, I'm going to do this glue up on the table saw. The frame's attached to side panels like this, except to attach it, I have to flip it upside down. The bottom overhangs the sides a bit here, and I don't want it getting caught on that edge, so I'll bevel that, and I think that's easiest while I still have it up on the table saw. To help position the lid, I'm going to put this cleat on the inside of the lid like this. Now I'm going to put another cleat on the other side of the lid, but how to line that up, I can't really do that from the inside, so I thought of a trick. I'm using a pair of wedges to try to hold this thing in place. So I added this tab and a notch here, and that makes sure the lid only fits on one way. Well, I managed to get into the shipping crate just barely.